a bullet train whizzes by. This is the Shinkansen, pride of Japan. 2009 is the 45th anniversary of the Shinkansen's debut. Over the decades, it has carried over 8 billion passengers, more than the world's population. The Shinkansen is very popular with children and adults alike. And some die-hard fans just love taking pictures of these high-speed trains. The history of the Shinkansen is about a quest for speed to make the world's fastest train. The engineers behind it worked tirelessly, motivated by the hopes of a nation recovering from the devastation of war. The technology they developed won the world's admiration, and more countries are beginning to adopt the Shinkansen. On this edition of Begin Japanology, we look at the origins and appeal of the super high-speed train, the Shinkansen, the embodiment of Japanese dreams.
Hello and welcome to Begin Japanology. I'm Peter Barakan. On today's show, we'll be looking at the bullet train, or the Shinkansen, as it's known in Japanese. I'm standing in front of the main building of Tokyo Station, originally built in 1914, and as you can see, in the middle of a facelift now. This is the main national terminal for the Shinkansen trains. And this is one of the Shinkansen platforms. The trains leave every few minutes and run like clockwork. There's a staggering 600 departures and arrivals of Shinkansen trains here every day, making Tokyo Station one of the world's busiest rail terminals. And over here, this is the latest Shinkansen model, the N700 series. Its curved line has been compared to a diving hawk. Seen from the front, it also looks rather like a platypus. Either way, its line is extremely distinctive and is the result of state-of-the-art aerodynamic engineering. In its 45 years of operation, the Shinkansen has never had one single fatal accident involving operational error. Key factors in that amazing record include ceaseless technological innovation and also tremendous dedication on the part of a large number of people. First of all, let's take a look at just what kind of train the Shinkansen is.
The Shinkansen is the backbone of transportation in Japan. Speed, comfort, and beauty have earned these trains a special place in Japanese hearts. Shinkansen trains are a particular favorite of rail fans. Special events held all around Japan attract crowds of children and adults who just love these trains. Currently, the Shinkansen rail network extends 2,387 kilometers. It runs the length of the largest main island, Honshu, and beyond to the island of Kyushu in the southwest. Let's start in Tokyo. The Tokaido Sanyo Shinkansen line runs away to the west. The journey from Tokyo to Hakata is 1,196 kilometers, but today the whole trip may take as little as 5 hours. This line carries about 580,000 passengers every day. The principal rolling stock is the popular N700 series. Shinkansen lines also extend north to Niigata and Aomori. Diverse train models run on these lines, and they have distinctive names. The Asama train is named after a mountain in Nagano Prefecture. The Toki train is named for a bird that is the symbol of Niigata Prefecture. Many trains are named after local symbols. There is also a Shinkansen line in Kagoshima Prefecture, Kyushu. The trains that run on this line are called Tsubame, the Swallow, and feature a distinctive interior decor. Gold leaf walls. Decorative elements made with a traditional lacquering technique called makie. And armrests and tables with the warmth of real wood. The phone booth is partitioned off by a traditional noren curtain. Each Shinkansen service in the far-flung corners of Japan has a distinct personality. Bullet train services are defined above all by their speed, precision, and safety. First, speed. The first generation Shinkansen trains were the fastest in the world at that time, capable of 220 kilometers per hour. Today's trains can reach 300 kilometers per hour, such as the 500 series and the N700 series. Even faster trains that can hit 320 kilometers per hour are under development and are expected to enter service in 2010. Second, precision. From this control center of the Central Japan Railway Company, operating conditions are monitored in real time and instructions are issued. Even though hundreds of trains run at very short intervals throughout the day, on average each train is no more than 10 seconds early or late. The Shinkansen just has to be the world's most punctual train service. Third, safety. The Shinkansen system does not employ signals. Because the trains run at such high speeds, by the time a signal was seen and the possibility of danger acknowledged, it would be too late. So a pioneering automated train control system was developed. The tracks are divided into 1 kilometer block sections. If the train running behind closes in and enters the block behind where the preceding train is, the system sends an instruction to the succeeding train to decelerate to 30 kilometers per hour. If the gap keeps closing, the train is automatically stopped to prevent a collision. This train is nicknamed Dr. Yellow. It's used for track inspection. As it moves, it carefully checks the tracks for distortion and the overhead cables for wear. To ensure safe operations, maintenance and inspection by people is also important. Every night, a crew of 3,000 workers checks the tracks. Even a vertical displacement of just 6 millimeters over a distance of 10 meters is outside the tolerances. Expert eyes ensure that the track alignment is millimeter accurate. Tremendous effort goes into maintaining the Shinkansen's record of speed, safety, and high precision operation so that the bullet trains keep running without a hitch.
On display behind me here is the Zero Series Shinkansen, which was the first model to go into service back in 1964. Before this, electric trains had a big, boxy appearance, but this Zero Series Shinkansen had an aerodynamic design, including this big bulbous nose, kind of fast and bulbous, if you like. People considered this unusual design extremely cool, and it became an instant classic. Although, sadly, the last of this Zero Series were taken out of service last year. And this is what it looked like in the driver's seat. As you can see, the speedometer here goes up to 260, although in normal operations, the train would travel at a maximum speed of 220 kilometers per hour, making it still the fastest train in the world at that time. In fact, the Shinkansen sparked an international boom in high-speed train development. For the Japanese people rebuilding the country after the devastation of World War II, the Shinkansen was a source of inspiration. In fact, they call it the Dream High-Speed Train. And this dream was realized by the heroic efforts of a team of engineers.
When the Second World War came to an end in 1945, the Japanese people had next to nothing. They didn't even have enough food to eat. But starting in the 1950s, the economy began to surge. This was the so-called economic miracle. People began to glimpse a vision of a brighter future. In 1964, Tokyo hosted the Olympics. Many large-scale projects were undertaken in conjunction with this milestone event. The development of a new rail system was one of the dreams shared by the nation. It was also necessary. In the booming economy, people were flooding into the cities and overloading the transportation infrastructure. In those days, the Tokyo-Osaka route was being served by a special express train called Kodama. The trip took 6.5 hours, but the Kodama couldn't keep up with demand. The Shinkansen was proposed as a way to meet heavy demand and to give wings to Japanese dreams. Development began on a new high-speed railway that would link Tokyo and Osaka in just 3 hours. At the time, the world's fastest train was the French Mistral, which had a top speed of 160 kilometers per hour. Japanese engineers set their sights on a speed of 200 kilometers per hour. But to achieve that goal, various hurdles would have to be overcome. The design of the Shinkansen train body was entrusted to Tadanao Miki, an engineer who had been involved in the design of fighter planes during the war. What shape would enable the train to run fastest? During the war, Miki had been entrusted with the design of planes used for kamikaze missions. These planes had no landing gear, and they had streamlined noses to enable them to smash into enemy ships even faster. Again and again, the special planes designed by Miki plunged from the skies into the heat of battle and were lost. I felt terrible for the young men who died. It was hard to bear. Miki wanted to put his engineering talents to work for a peaceful purpose, but how? Then the idea came to him. Use the streamlined shape of those fighter planes for the Shinkansen to cut wind resistance and boost the train's speed. If we want a beautiful airflow, we must give it a beautiful shape. That was Miki's guiding philosophy as he crafted one clay model after another. There was another major hurdle on the path to higher speeds. The horizontal vibration of the carriage wheels, called hunting motion, that occurs at high speed. If the hunting motion becomes severe, the wheels may slip off the rails and cause a serious accident. Tadashi Matsudaira was assigned to tackle this problem. To make the train faster, we had to minimize the hunting motion. We couldn't rest until we got it under control. Matsudaira's solution was to improve the spring suspension. The springs on ordinary trains were designed to make the ride more comfortable, so they were designed strictly to absorb vertical oscillations. Matsudaira's concept was to employ springs using air pressure that could check both vertical and horizontal vibration simultaneously. Meanwhile, Miki had drawn up plans for the train body and made a prototype. The beauty of the finished train took people's breath away. A 32-kilometer test course was constructed. The day of the trial run was approaching. Then one day, Miki abruptly handed in his resignation. To the astonished staff, he said, "I've put everything I know about engineering into that train." I had discharged my duty. I felt confident leaving the rest up to the others. At last, on March the 30th, 1963, the trial run was held. The goal was a speed of 200 kilometers per hour. The moment had arrived for Japanese technology to rewrite the record books. As the man in charge of tests, Matsudaira was on board. the train slowly rolled into motion. Inside, the engineers focused intently on their instruments. ...140, 150, the train steadily picked up speed. Tension was running high. Instruments were detecting the lateral vibration that they had feared. Should the trial run be halted, everyone looked at Matsudaira. But Matsudaira did not press the emergency stop button. He was convinced that the springs would absorb the vibration. And indeed, they did. That day, the train achieved its goal, 200 kilometers per hour. And it kept going faster and faster, clocking a top speed of 256 kph. It was the fastest train in the world. Japan's dream high-speed train was now a reality. For all the engineers who had vowed to use their expertise for peaceful purposes, this was the moment when their efforts were finally rewarded. I simply felt it was the result that our theory and calculations had led us to expect. Mickey watched the record-breaking achievement at home on TV. I was certainly glad that we'd done it, that we had a train capable of running at 256 kilometers per hour. In 1964, a year and a half after the record-breaking trial run, the Shinkansen went into service. The public were asked to propose a nickname for the train, and 560,000 suggestions came in from across the country. The world's fastest train offered a vision of a bright future for Japan. The most popular suggestion was Hikari, which means light. And that's how the Hikari Shinkansen got its start, speeding along the rails, a symbol of Japan's hopes for a great future.
This is a hobby shop, and take a look at these glass cases. They're full of trains, all kinds of different trains, incredibly elaborate models, and very expensive as well. And you can find Shinkansen models as well in here. Once you've got your train, of course, you've got to have some track to run it on, and they've got all kinds of different types of track here, including bridges and curves and all those things, points as well, of course. And on this side, they've got various kinds of grass and turf, different types of foliage, even some little cherry blossom trees here. Quite amazing. And how about this then? You can rent this track layout by the hour and bring in your own trains to run on it. We've got two different kinds of Shinkansens here, plus the yellow inspection train as well. This really is quite fun. Train spotting is a quintessentially English hobby, but Japan has its train buffs equal to any country's in their obsessiveness. Some of them like to collect trains, some of them like to collect train-related merchandise, others just like to ride the rails. There are some who even like to record the sounds of trains. And now, we're going to meet someone whose hobby is photographing Shinkansen trains.
Japan has a real passion for the Shinkansen. Many people are devoted to capturing the ultimate image of a bullet train for posterity. Kunihiko Tsuji is one such photo enthusiast. He's been taking photos of the Shinkansen for 20 years. Whenever he goes out with his camera, he always takes a ladder that extends up to 3.5 meters. This is essential in helping him get the best angle for a shot. His father worked for the former National Railways, and Tsuji has loved trains ever since he was a boy. Eventually, his interest focused on taking photos of trains. All through his adult life, Tsuji has been taking photos unlike anybody else's. He specializes in Shinkansen trains, which are tough because they move so fast. Tsuji has taken more than 50,000 Shinkansen photos. Some of these trains are traveling at up to 300 kilometers per hour, but he makes them look as if they're standing still. He uses a maximum shutter speed of 1/8,000th of a second. Tsuji's skill is legendary even among professional photographers, and his photos have graced the cover of many train magazines. The ultimate challenge is to capture the full length of a Shinkansen train in a single shot. What makes this so difficult is that sound-blocking walls along the tracks often obstruct the view. But in Tsuji's photos, you do see the whole train. The toughest thing of all is finding the best spot to shoot from. Tsuji makes meticulous preparations. He watches specialist videos shot entirely from the viewpoint of the train driver. These show the scenery rushing past for the whole length of a journey. Videos like this are very popular with rail fans because they make you feel as if you're actually driving the train. But Tsuji uses them differently. He goes through the video frame by frame to figure out locations where his view of the train will be unobstructed. There's no sound-blocking wall on this side, so it should be possible to get a clear view of the undercarriage of the Shinkansen. But I won't know if it's possible to set up a shop until I actually get there. The next day, Tsuji heads out to the location. Just as he expected, there's nothing to obstruct his view of the Shinkansen. It's an ideal spot, but the elevation is too low to get a good angle. So he grabs his ladder and heads off up the hill, looking for a little extra height. Good. Super. Here's the spot that Tsuji has picked. Now he's finally ready to shoot. Here it is. From nose to tail, the whole of a 16-car train is in the shot. Another important task is preparing a customized Shinkansen timetable. Railway personnel use these diagrams as well. It's a super detailed timetable, showing not only the times of departure and arrival at each station, but also the time when the train is at intermediate points between stations. Once Tsuji has found the spot he wants to shoot from, he checks this chart to see when the train will pass. Making expert use of this timetable, Tsuji captures the moment when two Shinkansen trains pass each other. A masterpiece, made possible by exhaustive analysis of time and location. Tsuji never uses the camera's motor drive to take a series of shots. For him, it all boils down to capturing the Shinkansen at 300 kilometers per hour in one single shot. Got it. Super. Just one split second packed with tension and drama. That's what Tsuji lives for. Today, Tsuji is after a Shinkansen shot unlike any he has taken before. He wants to capture the moment when a train blasts out of a tunnel. The tricky part is that he won't be able to see the Shinkansen until the moment before it emerges. The sound. Sound is the key. For this shot, he's going to rely on sound alone to get the timing right. The Shinkansen will be travelling at 300 kilometers per hour. Tsuji will press the shutter when the train is only 5 meters away from him, and he will take just one picture. His window of opportunity will last just a fraction of a second. Wow. Did I get it? Take a look. It's an outstanding shot, but Tsuji is not satisfied. 50 centimeters, that's 5 millimeters in this photo. If I'd shot the train just that much further ahead, this photo would score between 90 and 95 points. Tsuji's quest is for Shinkansen moments that no one has ever photographed. And his thirst for perfection just cannot be quenched.
Japan's Shinkansen trains are extremely safe. Elaborate measures are taken to prevent collisions. And the system also features outstanding earthquake response technology. In addition, the trains run with incredible punctuality. And despite their high speed, they're designed to cope with slopes of demanding angles, which is characteristic to Japan. Basically, these trains can do whatever is required of them wherever they run. Many countries around the world, and especially places with fast-growing economies, have plans to construct high-speed rail lines. And Japan's advanced Shinkansen technology is attracting a great deal of attention. In fact, the Shinkansen is going global. And we'll leave you today with a look at just where it's headed.
Taiwan's high-speed railway began service in 2007. This was the first time Shinkansen technology had been used outside Japan. In the same year, China also began to adopt the Shinkansen's manufacturing technology. In 2009, Vietnam confirmed its own intention to introduce the Shinkansen. And now the United States is interested as well. In April, as part of economic stimulus efforts, the US government proposed the introduction of high-speed railways.
I'm announcing my administration's efforts to transform travel in America with an historic investment in high-speed rail.
But in the international arena, the Shinkansen faces a formidable rival, the French TGV. In 2007, the TGV clocked 574.8 kilometers per hour, a new world record. These trains already run at up to 320 kilometers per hour in daily operation and have been introduced in South Korea. Backers of the Shinkansen have begun actively pitching Japan's product to the US. Meanwhile, there are plans for trial runs using an existing Shinkansen train that will outpace the TGV. The Shinkansen came into existence carrying Japanese hopes for a brighter future. Now those hopes are on the fast track to global success. Next time on Begin Japanology, marriage. We look at courtship, weddings, and married life in Japan.